Level 2. Let's go. Oh. So slow. Okay, we'll see what that says. Thank you, Crobat.
Damn. Whoa, really?
Oh, Drifling, nice. Bloody missed it. Oh wow, Crystal Cavern. Actually does eat it.
Nice.
I definitely have to redo this level. That was cool. I wonder if you level this up enough if you find Diancie. I'd put money on the fact you get to see a Diancie at like level 4 or 5, or I don't know how high the levels go. Not even Pokemon photographed. Nice. Noibat, what's my highest? 3. That one. Carbink. I'm just gonna go that one. Well, that was a 4 star. Nice. Thank you, Terry. Better, even though I won't beat it. Pick a little munchkin. I had 2s and 3s before.
Now that. A new discovery.
Oh, so close.
Nice work.
And we won.
Nice work.
Guessing this one's just 4-star because he's rare. Oh, we won. Nice. I say we won, but it's all me.
Nice work. A new discovery. Nice work.
Whoa, 2 points off diamond.
Nice work. Great timing.
New Pokemon, not quite centered, but
perfect timing.
Oh, we got diamond on that, even though I screwed up.
Nice work.
Wow, I need a 4-star Sableye now. I don't know how many points I got that time. Dying crystals. Dragon collector. Ooh, I saw Goodra. That must mean maybe Goodra's the one for this island. Oh. Now we figured out something. I didn't actually miss anything. Oh well, I don't have to redo that one then. Just imagine, plants thriving so deep underground. What wonders the world hides. Professor. Hey, Professor, what was that important thing you wanted to tell us? Ah, yes, good news. We've located an aluminum Pokemon on Duras Island. That's right, we've picked up a familiar reading coming from a large empty space deeper in the cave. Which means we've found our last Lumion Pokemon. You know what to do, trusty photographer. Sorry, my back's itchy. Feels weird.
All right. Here.
Oh, it's daytime. I wonder what it is. Let's see. Also, let's not screw this up like the last one. I mean, we didn't screw it up. We just didn't do it as good as possible. Also, you guys have 4 minutes left on stream, right?
Looks like your target is... there!
Ah, here's the Steelix.
Rushing up to it could be dangerous. Be careful.
He must be in one of those holes, right? Try throwing clubfruit at them.
Oh, there. I thought they might do Steelix as well as a reminiscent of Crystal Onyx. Him up now. Sometimes these aluminum orbs can be tricky to get a hold, like, handle on. There we go. Are you kidding? I missed it. Ah! Not happy about that. Not happy, Jan. But before you praise it, let me burba. Alright, sorry, I had to clean up someone's stank. Alright, come on. And I had to pee as well. Let me get my legs right, and you won't fall bum in the gap. There you go. Let me get my controller. LOL. No photos.
You mind?
That was embarrassing. Get down, buddy. Here you go. Have that, no, you know what? Whatever. Alright, come back up. You're the one who wanted to go down. Oh, sorry, knocked your back, baby. No, we don't play with this. No. No. Me?
Return, could I trouble you to make a quick detour? Something caught my attention while you were chasing after that Steelix. Past that broken wall, there appears to be a large open area. The scan says it's not a natural formation, it's human-made. It's just begging to be explored. For sure, but I think it may be another ruin connected to the Illumina Pokemon. very old, and it's missing some pieces here and there. But it must be depicting that ancient lentil legend. Let's see. It looks like it's roughly 2,000 years old?
Jeez, you startled me. Is it really that old?
It must have been made around the time the meteorite hit. Fantastic! What a discovery!
Does this show what the people saw back then? So, the Pokemon are protecting them from the meteorite?
The patterns on these Pokemon. Could they be Illumina Pokemon? Did Illumina Pokemon exist before the meteorite fell after all? And was there another Illumina Pokemon in the center?
Professor?
Oh, sorry. I got a bit lost in thought. I've got some good data for now. Let's sort it out once you're back.
That was cool.
It was really cool, wasn't it, Bobby?
Okay, let's see which Steelix photo we should pick. Oh, we only got one. Ours. What do you mean that one didn't count? That one's my... Didn't have the best time with the last two Voluminous, hey.
Excellent. Nice work.
Now we still got Diamond. Underground Guardian. Comic. Nothing to report. Let's go. Return to camp. Research camp settings, others. I'm gonna have a look at that.
To explore before our survey comes to an end. Ready for the final frontier?
That mural has turned my whole theory on its head. Not only is there another Illumina Pokemon, but they have also been around since before the meteorite.
Oh?
Is it just me, Professor? Or is that excitement in your voice? Mm-hmm. Is it not just you? This wasn't what I expected, but it's a fascinating awesome. Discovery. Plus, I've gone all over our data, and it shows that energy from all over Lentil is converging in one spot. And in that same spot, we picked up a very faint reading for an Illumina Pokemon. The central one from the mural? It seems it. So where is it? Now that's the tricky part. This point on this tiny island doesn't even appear on the map. And there, most likely, is where we'll find the island spoken of in legend, Aurus Island. Time for one final exploration. Let's find the truth once and for all. Now, a couple things before I go. First off, settings. Oh, it's that all. 94, yeah! In the top 100 of my language, and in the top 1,000 or 760. It's done well. Why are you vibrating? I want to change one thing. Prefer my language there. Alright. Let's explore some ruins. Oh, I know what I wanted to check anyway.
What massive ruins? The reading was coming from deeper inside. Be careful.
That one seemed as if it's lit up. Holy crap, that's cool. For him. Okay, where's the Woobats? There'll be something about lining each one of these things up. Damn it, I missed the jump. Hey, Natu. My only thing is, I don't want them to have Pokemon without their evolutions, because that's going to annoy me. Okay, I think you got a couple of good picks.
Didn't I, Bobby? I got a couple of good picks.
Hello.
Not only 8 Pokemon photographed. Okay, what is... I got a 3-star, which was the 1-star. Eldegoss, I got a 3-star. Natu. Oh, I got a 4-star. Sleepy Sleep. Oh, actually, I got 2 4-stars. That one's better. I'll lurk. They're all 1. I like that one. Noivern, just a 1-1-star. Salandit, I got a 3-star. That one. Twins. Crystal Bloom. Best, even though it was crap. 3-star. Oh, wait, is it? No, that one is. Alright.
Let's do this. A new discovery. Great timing.
Nice diamond straight off the bat. Good start. I actually do really like that photo.
Nice work.
Now I think of it, do we actually have many Sword and Shield Pokemon in this?
A new discovery. Nice work.
It's fine, I love getting the 4-star out of the way earlier. I like that pick.
Great timing.
Nice, diamond. Deserves it. Yes.
A new discovery. Great timing. A new discovery. Perfect timing.
Just trying to intimidate you. Diamond. I don't know why I was looking at that like it was going to be assessed then.
A new discovery.
Oh, I don't think I got it to level 2 yet. Accomplished research team. Fire collector, ground collector, assistant detective scan function 60 research spots. Huh. Yeah, I know you have something.
Let's go. Yo, yo.